Hi friends, I am Sai Chaitanya. Welcome to Sai Tech Guru. In this video, I'm going to compare the Realme X2 versus the Poco X2 device. So this is the most requested video which a lot of subscribers are asking me recently. So I decided to make a video, friends. And be patient, friends, because this video will be very much longer than the expected. I try to do it very smaller, but there's a lot to explain in terms of the lot of areas. As you can see, a processor, battery, display, camera, and other features. So which will take plenty of time while doing this video. So definitely, friends, watch till the end. You will get a clear clarity which phone to buy. If you are a gamer, or if you are a traveler, or if you are just normal person who wants the phone, then you will get a clear clarity, friends. And before starting the video, if you're first time watching this video, friends, don't forget to check the links in description for the playlist of Poco X2 and the Realme X2. As you can see, friends, I already uploaded plenty of videos on the Realme X2. More than 100 videos are uploaded, and even the Poco X2, definitely it will cross 100 videos very soon. Subscribe to my channel, friends, if you want to get notified any other future updates in the future, because I won't be selling these devices very soon. So definitely I'll be keeping these devices, and all the updates I'll be reviewing again and again. So don't forget to subscribe, friends, if you want to know future updates about this mobile. And without any getting delay, let's get started with the first main thing is the processor. And before starting the video, friends, don't forget to check the links in description for the wallpaper what I'm using. As you can see, there are wallpapers specially designed for the notched phones and specially designed for the Poco X2 as well. So where you can hide this kind of front camera, and which looks pretty good. And let me get back to the test right now. And the first thing which nowadays lot of users are noticing is that in terms of the processor, and nowadays before buying the device, lot of users are cared about the processor to be very good and to be future proof. And in this case, both the phones are pretty good, a Snapdragon 730G, so that's a good score and tie between both the phones. There is no problem at all in terms of the processor. And next is in terms of the battery. So these were the things get a little bit of change. First thing, first advantage, let me talk about the advantages of Realme X2 device. So first advantage is the charging speed, so which is a 30 watts charger. So that is the biggest advantage. Why I'm saying biggest, because I'll explain you again in this video. And this has a 27 watts. So you may think there is not much difference in terms of the watts, then why you're giving points to the Realme X2 device? Why I'm giving is that Realme X2 phone has very fast charging even while you are using the device. That is not quite often in the Redmi phones, which take a pretty longer time while charging the device if you are using the phone. For example, if you are playing a PUBG game and your phone percentage is at 20% in the Realme X2 device, and it takes maybe 1 hour 20 minutes or 1 hour 30 minutes to charge. But if the same situation, if it comes to the Poco X2, it takes 2 hours, 3 hours and 4 hours. It takes so much long time. So these were the I didn't like about the Poco X2 and even the Redmi phones previously which I owned. So that's why, friends, trust me, if you are a gamer, then definitely buy the phone which has high charging speed, because most of the time you can get full charge for about maybe 4 to 5 hours if you are playing the games, and rest of the game you need to connect the phone to the cable and you need to play the game. So if you are playing like that for continuously longer times, longer duration, then this will even impact the battery life or battery efficiency of the phone as well. So definitely this is the main reason why I'm giving points to the Realme X2 device, mainly because charging rate is pretty higher than the Poco X2 phone. So this is what I noticed after long term using the Realme X2 phone and Realme phones as well. Not only X2, even the same thing with the Realme X, X2 Pro, and which is very fast charging, even if you are playing the game, doesn't matter. So that's why I given the points. And in terms of the screen on time, friends, the battery life, I feel both are good. And one thing is that the screen on time, I felt a little bit of extra in the Realme X2 phone, even though the battery size is a 4000 mAh, but still I got more than the expected in the Realme X2 phone when compared with the Poco X2 device. So this is what I noticed after using the mobile phones for a couple of weeks. So another thing to be noted is that I'm not partial to any phone manufacturer, and no other phone manufacturer is giving the mobile phones for the reviews. You need to keep that in mind, friends, and I'm just giving my all opinions about both the phones. because this might be useful to a lot of users. And next area is a display. So this is where the things get a little bit of change, because why I'm saying, you might think the Realme X2 has got super AMOLED panel, then definitely X2 will be the clear winner. But wait for the another twist which has got in the Poco X2 is that not the 120Hz. That is not the twist. There is another twist where you can change the colors in the Poco X2. So right now the Realme X2 has got the AMOLED panel, which is very good. I am very happy with the AMOLED panels as well. And Poco X2 has got 120Hz display refresh rate. That is the first advantage. And next advantage is that you can change the color saturation levels in the Poco X2 device. So which recently I'm doing all the display comparisons as well again in the Poco X2 by changing the color saturation levels. So what I mean is that, let me explain you friends clearly. So in the Poco X2 phone, if you go to the game speed booster and additional settings, and if you select any other media application like MX Player, YouTube or Amazon Prime, you'll get this kind of option to increase the colors. You can see there is a significant increase in terms of the color levels and brightness levels. So this will be very helpful while playing the games, because you can even easily spot the enemies even in the darker situations as well, which is very good and advantage in the Poco X2. And let me demonstrate the video, friends, MX Player and side by side. So let me play the same video in Realme X2 and the Poco X2 device, and you can get the clear clarity why I am stressing this much about the Poco X2 phone. In the beginning, I did not phone this future, friends, and later I just try to check whether it's present or not. Definitely it's present in the Poco X2, because before phone was Redmi K20 Pro, which has the same kind of feature. And right now you can see if you notice or not in this video, but the colors are very high and very darker, like brighter in the Poco X2 device. If you notice here the plans, you can see here. So let me spot a few scenarios where I felt like that. See, when the brightness is very high in the Poco X2 phone, friends, so that is another advantage in the display also. So let me try to decrease to 10% and show you what's the difference is. So you can see, if I try to decrease the brightness, you can see how much brighter it is in the Poco X2. So where the phone, both the phones are having same brightness levels in the MX Player 10-10, but still Poco X2 has got a more brightness. So this is what I'm talking, friends. You'll get extra brightness levels and extra saturated levels than the Realme X2 phone. As you can see, you're comparing side by side, and this is not the display comparison review, so I won't be stressing much about this kind of things here. So definitely I'll be doing separate video also demonstrating you extreme, moderate and normal settings side by side. So definitely for the Poco X2 is a clear winner in terms of the display, because it has got 120Hz refresh rate also, which is a future proof as well if you want a phone with a 120Hz refresh rate. And next is a camera area. So yeah, the few samples in terms of the front camera clarity as well. As you can see, friends, the clarity in the Poco X2 is a little bit of better than the Realme X2, but not that significant in terms of the clarity of the front cam. And let me show you the other images which are taken with the macro shot as well. As you can see, friends, Realme X2 versus the Poco X2 device. Let me show you the 64 megapixel shot which I have taken. So this is a 64 megapixel ultra shot which I have taken, friends, and let me try to zoom to the text so where you can clearly see whether you can read the text or not actually. So if you notice here, friends, the text on the Realme X2 is pretty good, but not on the Poco X2 device. So which I tried to take multiple shots, but still this is the same scenario which has happened. So this one thing to be noted, even the Redmi Note 8 Pro performed very good in terms of the 64 megapixel ultra shot, but I'm not sure why it's happening in the real Poco X2 device. And let me show you the night shot which are taken in the Realme X2 phone, and let me try to compare side by side with the X2 device. So as you can see, friends, this is a normal scenario, and this is a night mode scenario. And let me try to zoom in. as you can see friends, the text on the back side little bit got washed away on the Realme X2 device, but not on the Poco X2 phone, as you can see here slightly. So overall friends, these are the changes which are seen in the camera. So in terms of the camera, I can give the points the slightly better to the Poco X2 device, not for the Realme X2 device, only for the front cam. And definitely these are like, these two phones are pretty good in the camera, so I can, maybe it's a tie option, not which is best. And next is in terms of the other features. So other features which indicates there are like plenty of features which I want to discuss. And first is the face ID scanning, which I'll be concentrating right now, and next fingerprint and everything. So first is the face ID unlocking friends. So both the phones are really good in the face ID unlocking, there's no problem at all. And in the fingerprint test is the Realme X2 has got the in-display fingerprint sensor, which is another advantage when compared with the side-mounted fingerprint sensor. For example, if you place your phone on the table and if you just want to unlock the device, you don't need to even lift the phone friends, just by placing the finger you can unlock and you can access the phone. But in the Poco X2 device, you need to register few fingers to unlock the device. So which is kind of disadvantage I can say, but in terms of the fingerprint option, the Realme X2 is a winner. And stay here friends, because there are plenty of other options which I'll be discussing right now, which has additional advantage in the Realme X2 device than the Poco X2. So which has got a dual Wi-Fi connection as well. As you can see friends, two Wi-Fi connections you can use at same time, and all these applications are supported currently. And not only with that friends, you also have the Wi-Fi tethering option as well, which is very good. And for the first time I used in the Realme X phone, and till now I did not stop using that friends, because even in the OnePlus 7 Pro or Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus, the Wi-Fi connection, there used to be a problem in that. But as soon as I start to use the Realme phones, this is the biggest thing I notice, and a lot of YouTubers never mentioned this before, but the Wi-Fi connection in the Realme X2 is pretty good and very strong when compared with the normal Redmi phones. So this is the one thing which I noticed. So if in terms of the connectivity, the Realme X2 is a winner. And even not only that friends, it has got extra options as well, and which includes a black and white mode as well friends, as you can see here. So which has a black and white mode, so you can read all the ebook readers directly without any problem. So which is another advantage I can say. And next is having the dark mode. In the Realme X2 is supported in all the applications from the Play Store friends, even the WhatsApp or Facebook, Instagram, all the applications, which is another advantage in the Realme X2 device. So all these kind of features which are very good present in the Realme X phone device friends, dual Wi-Fi connection, black and white mode. I know this won't be useful for most of the users, but still these are the points to be noted if you are deciding to buy the phone, which phone to buy. So in the other category, I can give the points to the Realme X2 device. And overall friends, the Poco X2 has got only advantage of having like, I think, 120Hz refresh rate. Apart from that, I cannot see any other advantage in the Poco X2 when compared with the Realme X2 device friends, definitely. So even with the 120Hz also, if you are a gamer, then definitely you can go for the Poco X2. And if you are just like a normal person who uses a phone just for calling and texting and few WhatsApping, that's it, then Realme X2 is the best option, because it's very small and single, and usage is very quite possible in the Realme X2 device when compared with this phone, 6.67 inches. So this is the overall review friends. Sorry for taking this much of so long video, and trust me, by this time you would have got clear idea which phone to buy and why to choose. See you in the next video friends. Until then, stay tuned. Bye.